Very good morning and good afternoon to everybody who've joined. Just a small request to everybody, please change your profile name, oblique the country that you're representing. This will help us during the conversations, during the sessions. For steps on that, you can see there will be three buttons appearing against your profile name. Click on those three buttons and there'll be an option to rename picture. And you can click on rename and rename it is your name followed by the country. Thank you. We'll be starting in another 1 minute. A very good morning and good afternoon to everybody who joined today. Thank you for joining the day two of the online training on women entrepreneurs on expanding online business through e-commerce and digital marketing. Before we begin, I'd like to share a few house rules for all the participants. One, request you to all to please unmute your microphones and switch off your videos. Second, as told before, change your profile name as name oblique the country. And for any queries during the Q&A session, you may raise your hand or switch on your video during the break or during the Q&A, or feel free to even write in the chat box whenever you're feeling any issues. So let's begin with the session one of the day. But before we begin of the session one, I'll request our session Ms. Dipali, to please spend a few minutes on yesterday's session on registering on VSEL Online and take everybody through that website once again. In case anyone has any issues, feel free to share with us. Thank you. Dipali ma'am, you have the floor. Ma'am, we aren't able to hear you. Yes, now you go ahead.
Yeah, sorry. Good afternoon, everybody. And I'm sure yesterday's session was very fruitful. You all must have gone to Facebook and tried to create your account and Facebook got crashed yesterday. So today we'll further proceed with VSEL Online, and we have seen how to create account. And there were some queries and some people couldn't connect and couldn't create the account. So let me today again go through it. I'll share my screen. So first you go to www.vselonline.org and then you have this page. This is the page where we are listing the popular categories and the entrepreneurs and buy from which country, like we are listing country wise. So what we'll do is we'll go to login, and in login we have drop down of customer and entrepreneur. Now because your role is entrepreneur, so you click on entrepreneur here, and don't go for this login because you have not created the account. Those people who have created the account will go for the login. Yesterday Upasana had this question because she was thinking that only after login she'll be able to create account. First you have to create the account, then only you'll be able to log in. So go on entering the information here, like name, middle name, last name, and whether you, it is only for female, so by default it is female only, and select the email and the password. You have to select with the one capital letter, minimum one capital letter, one character, and minimum one strange character, strong characters, and it's combination of alphanumeric. So numbers also you have to enter. Then enter the mobile number, address, contact details, and select the business type. product category, service category, currency. If you are into service also, you can sign up. Yesterday there was a question whether I am into HR services, can we register? So yes, definitely, if you are a service provider like travel agent, beauty service provider, or any other CA, doctor, all basically, we are planning to create a network of women entrepreneurs. So even professionals and service providers, you can register here. That's why we are not kept the taxation like GST and all mandatory. And then you choose the identity proof document, which should be only in the format of JPG, PNG and PDF. And then select the profile picture, upload it in the form of JPG. I'm sure you must be using a lot of government sites where such forms are available. Even creating your email ID, you need to fill up a form. So this is very simple form, and I'm sure you must be able to do it in less than 5 minutes if your document is ready. And then write your firm name, write a short profile about yourself also and about your business, and then select I'm not robo and accept terms and condition, and then submit. So once you do all this, you will be getting your account ready. And then hope you remember your password. If you don't remember, you go here and just say forgot password. After you click on forgot password, you'll get link to your email, and from there you can reset your password. So till this point, till this registration of account and creation of entrepreneur account, anyone has any doubts, you can ask me, because only after you create the account, you'll be able to upload the products or services. Also, you'll be able to place inquiries. So can you try now, those who have not created any accounts? You can try creation of account. Any doubts?
Anyone was able to struggle to register yesterday after the workshop, feel free to ask. Okay, the Upasana. Okay, one moment, Upasana. I'll unmute you. Yes, Upasana, you may continue, please.
Yeah, I just need to let everybody know over here. You know, I was very struggling with making that password and trying to log in, and I was not able to because of a very simple practical problem that my password was more than 15 letters. So I think that's what was stopping me from, you know, creating mine. So I just need everybody to be just careful and mindful of, you know, the number of letters and this thing they're kind of choosing for the password, the length of the password. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Is anybody have? Dipali ma'am, there's a question coming in from Tazima. Do I need to do it again?
No, you need not do it again. I'm just taking questions only from those people who could not create it yesterday. Those who already created, they're good to go. Now you will be getting the further instructions like how to upload the product and all.
Is there anyone else who's facing questions? Additionally, I would also, sorry ma'am, I'd like to tell everybody that you can continue sharing your numbers, and we already created our colleague, my colleague Vaishnavi has created the WhatsApp group, and anybody who has not yet shared numbers yesterday during the day one of the training session, feel free to share your numbers right now on the chat box as well. We are creating the WhatsApp group. Anita, you'll have to share your contact number on the chat box, and my colleague Vaishnavi would add you to the group. And for everybody, anyone who's joined in new today, I'll request everyone to please try registering on VSEL Online. That's a platform for e-commerce that we've created. And this is like a training platform also. So once you are able to register here and upload your products and services here, you would be able to do that same in any other e-commerce platform as well, just like Amazon, Flipkart, or any other platforms. all the platforms on a similar similar way. So if we're able to do it here, we are very much pretty sure you'll be able to do it there also and do not have any struggles, face any struggles there. Ma'am, you may continue. Thank you.
Okay, so once we are done with creation of account, I'm sure now everybody has created their account. We'll go for the entrepreneur login. And then one by one, we'll see how to update the profile, how to add the products. So first, yesterday I have created this email ID I have used, so I'll use that. I'll give my password. Then I submit. And then I go to the dashboard. So this is the dashboard which you will be using for creation of your mini website or your catalog profile portal. So in this dashboard, right now I have 0 products, 0 inquiries, and even 0 services. So I'll go to the products master. And then I will first enter the brand because I'm giving some name of my company for the brand. So say my brand is giftwithlove.com. Okay, so this is my brand. So I'll give submit. So this is the brand which I have added. And then I will go to the product category. So what is the category for our reference? They have already given some categories. Gift items, florist, these are my categories. And also there are other categories like handicrafts, pet products, processed foods. So in case you don't find your category here, like if you think that you need a separate category, you please write to info@vcelonline or contact@vcelonline and we will add the category. And if you have any doubts, you can raise your hand or write in the chat box and then we will take that question. So first we will go again back and understand what we are doing. We are creating a profile on vcelonline.org. Here we want to add our products. That's why we will log into the dashboard. In the dashboard, we have product master. Master means it's a database. It is information which we are storing in the form of tabular format, in form of tables. So here we are creating the brand. So I have added one brand, giftwithlove.com. So I can also add one more brand.
Ma'am, we have a query from Geeta Regni from Nepal.
Okay.
Can I unmute her?
Yes.
Yes, Geeta, you can speak now, please.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My product is tea.
Okay.
Which category I should put?
You can select food if it food. Is.
There is no food category. There is only for sale.
Grocery food. And grocery it is, no? So you can add it in grocery and gourmet foods.
Tea. My product is tea.
Yeah. You can add it in the
grocery?
49 number. Yeah, grocery.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, welcome. So after that, I'm now seeing that what all items and categories are available. And also I'm seeing what all subcategories are available. So in agriculture, we have fertilizer. In agriculture, we have seeds. In agriculture, pesticides, crops, others like that. So each category, we have some subcategories. So in florist also, florist and cakes and florist flowers, florist flower basket, like that categories are created. So you can check this for your reference.
Ma'am, we have one more query coming in from Mr. Ali. Does product master dash product setting?
Sorry?
There's another query coming in from Ali. One moment, I'll ask. Mr. Ali, I have unmuted you. Can you go ahead, please?
Thank you. Thank you very much. I have a question that I see product master and service master. Does this mean that product or service setting or product setting?
Yeah, actually, this is for your reference only. You can't set it. Only the admin is setting.
These two menus are for setting the category, setting services or setting products, right?
It is for products, not for services.
The next one is services. Service master means service setting, right?
Yeah.
And product master means product setting.
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
Okay, Divya Rathod wants to ask, like, her product is chemical and they spray it on surface for stain repellent. Which category you can? Okay, so right now you can, what category it comes actually? Home appliances, not appliance. Divya, can you tell me what category you want it? I will add it now.
One moment, ma'am. Let me unmute her.
So it is related to...
Divya, are you there? Can you speak?
Home products.
Divya Rathod, are you there?
Can I ask the admin to add home products as one of the category?
Divya, you can put it on the chat box, please. We're not
Current
able
please
to
add home
to.
Products. Yeah. And home appliances also.
Divya, can you put it on the chat box, please? The question and reply to the question what Dipali Nam is asking, please. There's another question, Dipali, I'm in the meantime asking from Bini. I'm not being able to select the category and subcategory.
Yes, Bini, you should not select right now category and subcategory. When you go to add the product, that time you have to select. I will show it. Still, I have not reached that to that step. Right now, we are just seeing what all categories are there.
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt. There's one more question coming in from Tazima. I cannot fill out the account.
Oh, what problem you are getting, Tazima? Because if you don't have your identity proof or anything, you will not be able to submit. So what exactly problem you are facing, you can explain.
Ma'am, would you want me to unmute her?
Yeah.
Okay, Tazima, are you there? Tazima, are you there? Otherwise, please put on the chat box. Thank you. Go ahead, ma'am.
Yes. I can't make this work. I can go to the dashboard, but I cannot see the form.
That means you have already logged in. You have gone to the dashboard means?
Yeah, I went to the dashboard, but I cannot make it work.
Still we have not gone to anything further.
Oh,
we are
okay.
Just brand, could you add? Go to brand and select your add brand name title and okay. Say submit. Could you do that?
Okay.
Yeah, it's very simple.
Okay.
See, I'll select your brand name and then submit. So I have three brands, clickhubli.com, clickroses.com, giftwithlove.com. Suppose your name itself is brand, like my name is Dipali. So Dipali, myself, I am brand, like Ritu Berry and all. So I will just submit here.
No, I can't make it work.
Okay, Tazima, hold on for 2 minutes. Let ma'am continue and then we'll come back to you one on one.
Okay.
You give your phone number in the chat box.
And yes, somebody
from support team will call you in WhatsApp. Give her a WhatsApp call number.
Yeah.
Hopefully WhatsApp is working now.
Additionally, ma'am, there's similar query coming in from Tindley. My product is herbal tree, grains and flour. Where do I add my products?
You can add in the grocery and gourmet. Grocery and gourmet.
Okay, ma'am, there's another question coming in from yesterday asking, how do I upload my identity proof? Yesterday, I just added a random image.
We will go to that. We are in the dashboard. So in the dashboard, there is a profile also. See here, profile. So in this profile, you can add your identity proof. So here you can view the document. This is the document. Here you can add if it is not there. Add button will come. Update. And in update, you can add here. Choose the file, update or upload or change the identity proof. So choose the file. You can choose the file and upload it. You have to go here. On the top right corner, you have profile, and from there you can edit it. Update, you have to click. Okay, so we are in the product master. So product category we have seen, product subcategories we have seen. Now product size. So these are the sizes available, the units for the sizes, like one bag, one bottle, one bunch, one bundle, centimeter, dozen. Free size also is there in case you don't want to add any size. Like for sari and all, we don't add size, so it is free size. Grams, feet, inches, kilograms, liters, square feet, square meter, all the sizes and units we added here. XL, XXL and all. Okay, so I will go to the product color. So product colors are also available. All colors we have already added and kept. So this is the master. Master in the sense, from here we'll be selecting the specification for the product. The product category, brand, subcategory, product size and color. All these we are selecting from here. So these are the master for our references. Okay. So then we'll go to products and say add product. Okay. So I am a florist, so I am adding the flowers like 12 roses bunch, and then I will give the 12 rose 01. These are simply the codings. SKU is nothing but the coding what I am doing. Okay, so I am adding now description. Model is nothing but fresh roses, say model. Then this is my brand of, say, clickroses.com. So I add here clickroses. My main category is florist. My subcategory is flowers. And there is no third category. So it is in stock. And then I'll add the description as bunch of 12 fresh red roses. Tied with the silk ribbon. Okay. So what are the keywords for this? So now my keywords are roses delivery in India, fresh flowers delivery, sun flowers to India. These are the keywords what people will be searching in Google, and then they will reach this particular page. Okay. So I'll add meta description. Meta description also is for Google, because meta tags are given to guide the search engine that we are listing our particular product on those particular keywords or those particular description. So buy this beautiful fresh roses bunch for birthdays, anniversaries, weddings, etc. So I am writing a keyword which is related to birthday roses, birthday flowers, send flowers to India, send roses to India, fresh flowers delivery in India. So these are the keywords which I am using just to guide the Google that whenever somebody is searching on this particular keyword, my page should get ranked so that I will get orders for this. Okay, let me check the chat box first.
Ma'am, there's a from Deepthi suggested that she'll be uploading the products in the evening. Deepthi, I would request you to try uploading one product at least now, so that you'll at least get to know the steps to follow. And we are here online for you to help you in case you face any issues. And I've shared my email address and my colleague's email address on the chat box. You may contact us anytime, or you may even reach out to us through the WhatsApp. But in the meantime, in the session, I'll request you to please try at least uploading one product or one service so that it clarifies your doubts. Thank you.
Yeah, Simhang says that she wants to upload multiple products. Yes, it is possible. Multiple brands. Yes, it is possible. Even I have created 3-4 brands like clickhubli.com, clickrose.com, giftwithlove.com. So these are different brands. Deepali itself is also one of the brands. So you also can do that. Okay, so let us go ahead. So after that, you click on go next. And then you need to add the size and price for the same. So size is nothing but 12 roses and it's a bunch. So I can add here bunch.
I'm sorry to interrupt. Once you're done with the adding, could you again repeat, because they're on chat box, they're saying, could you guide once again on how to add a product? So you can continue what you're doing and then once again start with the...
Adding at least 3-4 products. So yes. You'll get the clarity.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, so yeah. So I added the size here as 12 and it is generally bunch. So I added here bunch. Length, width, height, weight, etc. is optional. You need not add that. Then mine is INR, which I have selected while creating my profile. So 500 INR, I'll select the price. And then suppose I want to give discount every time of 10%. Shipping charge, I want to add fixed charge. If I'm adding 100 rupees, I can add. You can also have multiplicative shipping charge, okay, which will be multiplied by the quantity. Suppose now there is one quantity. If the client selects two quantities, then the shipping charge will be doubled. So if I added a multiplicative shipping charge like 100 rupees, then for two quantities, it will be 200 rupees. But fixed shipping charge is fixed. 100 rupees is fixed. Anyway, here you are not accepting the payment, so don't worry too much. You can always talk to the customer and ask them to pay the proper shipping charges. Once you understand how much shipping charge is, depending on the distance and the weight of the product. Okay, so I'll save this. Okay, so I added product size and general. Now I'll add image for that. Okay, so for that I will select the size. Like for my bunch, I am selecting an image now. So for that you choose file. Red. Upload. Oh, I uploaded the sari. I'll remove this. One minute, I don't have any image. Okay, I will just go to my site and copy some of the images.
Ma'am, in the meantime, there's a question coming in from Sonam Sharpa asking, my cat product is incense sticks and incense power. Where do I add that? How do I categorize my product?
It comes in which category? We will add that category. You suggest the category for us.
And also would like to tell everybody that you may even add the product category later also.
Okay, so this is the image. So now my product is added. So again I'll go to add product. For those who didn't understand, for them again I'll create now. That was 12 red roses bunch. Now I'll create 12 mixed roses bunch. The ID is 12mix-01. Model is fresh roses. Select brand, click roses. Main category is florist. Subcategory is flowers. Then I say fresh bunch, fresh flowers, bunch of 12 mixed color roses. These are meta tags and meta information is optional, so you can leave it. Okay, if you want to add, you can add, otherwise you can leave it. I'm adding the price now, shipping charges. Save, add image, choose file. Colors you need not choose because it is nothing, but color of the product. Here now we have mixed roses, so I'm just adding the image for the bunch size. Upload. Okay, so this is the thing. Now I want to see, I will browse the portal, okay, and see how my products look. For that I'll go to entrepreneurs and I'll search by my name, Dipali. So on this I'm adding, this profile I'm adding flowers, Dipali Ghotadke. So you can see that two flowers bunches have been added. One is 12 roses bunch, 12 mixed roses bunch. So here price is 500. After 10% discount, the price is shown as 450. It is 550 after discount, 495. So this way you can add the products. If you want to go back to your dashboard, you have to go here, my account. So you will go to the dashboard. Now you have two products here. These are the two products. Okay, till this, how many people could upload any of the product or create a category or create a brand? Sorry, category you cannot create, only brand you can create. While adding size in size and price section, if size property doesn't apply to yours, please select sizes not applicable. This is the description given by technical support team. Just select not applicable if your price or size is not there in the list. We can start now. Upasana, you can start and just try adding one products.
Dipali ma'am, just to guide a little further, could you open the first dashboard page? And I request everybody to now start adding. Go or log in on the entrepreneur login. And ma'am, can you show the page of entrepreneur login and tell everybody where to enter the details?
Okay, right now I'm in the dashboard. I'll log out.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll start fresh. Okay. So I'll go to www.vsellonline.org. So this is the home page.
So has everybody been able to reach to the home page? Is anyone facing any issues to even reach to this page? You could put it on the chat box right now or raise your hands.
Okay, so after this, go to login, Antapuna. And if you don't have any account, you need to create by filling up this form. This I explained at least 7 to 8 times. So I'm sure this I need not explain now. You must be able to create now your login. So my email ID is this. I'll enter my password. Then I log into my dashboard. Then I go to Product Master and create the brand. Brand I'm creating because it will be under certain brand of mine. So you can create multiple brand. And I just saw in the chat box, somebody said that I want to upload 100 products. So bulk upload is possible or not? Yes, it is possible. Even I'll explain that. Okay, so then you understand what all product categories are there. What all product subcategories are there. Product sizes, what all units are there. Then product colors, which are colors are available. And after understanding all these specifications for any product through Product Master, I'll go to products and say add product. After going here, we get a simple form, which is much simple compared to Amazon and all, and then you can add your product. So now added 12 roses bunch. So I'll add 20 roses basket. So 20BS001. Model is fresh flowers. Brand click roses. Main category florist. Subcategory flower basket. Then add here fresh flowers basket of 20 red roses. Okay, roses basket is my meta keyword. Send roses basket to India is my keyword. In description, I'll add buy flowers from clickroses.com to send roses basket to India. Go next. Then size. Size now it is 20 flowers and it is a pack, you can say, or bundle, or now there is no basket, so I'll just say resize or not applicable. Then rate I will add as 800 rupees. Discount I want to give 5%. Shipping charge is say 150 rupees. Then save. Then I'll add images. So I will copy this image. Red roses basket. And I will go to VSell Online. Go here, scroll down. Choose file, select for what size, not applicable is the size, upload. Okay, so this is the image. Okay, so when I'll go to my product, view products, all products, I can see that three products are listed here. Okay, so we are listed three products. It's as easy as this. In half an hour's time, I'm sure up to 10 products profile you can create.
Ma'am, there's a query coming in. Could you please show how to enter for meta description?
Yeah. So again, I will add one more product, add product. So here, now I'll add Black Forest cake. It's a round cake model. Brand is say giftwithlove.com. Main category is processed food.
Dipali, I'm sorry to interrupt. Would it be possible for you to put headphones? We hear a lot of background noise.
Yeah, actually, now there is a break. I have a school near our office, so all the children are out. Okay, so here when you enter the description of the product, you have option to enter meta keywords and meta description. So Black Forest cake, fresh cake for birthday. So these are the meta descriptions and meta product keywords which I am adding here. So what is the doubt exactly? You are not finding where to add this.
There's a query coming in from Simhang. Simhang, we'll be sharing the training links with everybody post the trainings are over. In the meantime, if you have any query, feel free to raise your hand and I'll unmute you. Simhang, we are there to help you. Don't worry that you're a little slow. Just try to start doing it and we'll wait for you to do it. Don't worry.
So I'm adding meta description, that is birthday cake delivery services. Now I'll add the size.
Ma'am, there's a question coming in from Rituparna only with regard to the meta description. She's asking, should we put hashtags?
No, hashtag is not required because we will create that for you. Okay, so now I'm adding cake. So the size is in the form of kilograms. So this is half. So I say half or 0.5. Weight is 0.5. Rate is 600 rupees. I don't want to give any discount. Shipping charge 100 rupees. Save. Then I go to images, choose file, so it's Black Forest. So for this kilogram weight, I'll upload this file. Okay, so the cake is here. Then I will see products, view products. All products. Now I have even cake. If you feel that you have made any mistake, if you want to do anything changes and all, if you want, you can delete from here product Are you sure you want to delete this product? If you say okay, the product will get deleted. Or you can block this product. Now all the products are visible here. I'll go to the portal and I'll see under the name of Dipali. I have flower basket, others and flowers. So I have this flower basket. Then I have cake under my products. Then I have flowers. So four products I have uploaded here. Suppose I say I want to block this red roses basket. I will block this. Are you sure? Yes, updated successfully. So I'll go here, and if I refresh this page, the 12 roses basket, 12 rose bunch will not be displayed. Only 12 mixed roses bunch will be displayed because I have blocked that particular product. So suppose any product is out of stock, you can always block it. If you are not selling it, you can block it. Okay, let me check chat once. If possible,
in the meantime, I'll encourage everyone to try registering on BSEM online, and wherever you're facing problems, fish issues, do let us know. We're there to help you. Would anyone want anyone wants to raise their hand and ask a question, feel free. Tazima, I'll request you to start by logging in on the entrepreneur page. I believe you already have an account, so enter your username, password, and log in. And let us know where you're facing issues and raise your hand. We'll unmute you, please. Simhang, were you able to register? Is there any issues that you're facing on adding your products? Or for that matter, anyone who has any issues, we'll take a moment here and pause and take your questions.
Okay, she's asking for recording of this program, overall workshop. So I think
the recording will be shared with you post the trainings are done. We'll share the link with all the participants. Ma'am, there's a question for you. I uploaded my product images but are not able to see. Please help in how to upload.
Select view products? You can unmute her so that we
one moment. I'll do that. The same question from Siddhi Aki also. One moment. I'll unmute Jani first.
See here,
Jani, you can speak now. Go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. I upload my photos, but not unable to see. No,
in the products, you go to view products and select all products.
View products. Oh.
Go to products.
There is no images. I view the products, but no images to see. No.
Did you upload the image?
Yes, ma'am.
I think when you uploaded the image, no. See here. So you have to select image for which. Suppose now I'll go again step by step. So I will add now chocolate truffle cake. I'm adding for you again, so you can check here. I'm adding description and then I'll go next. Size is in 1 kg, kilogram, weight 1, rate I'll add here as 1000 rupees, discount 10%, shipping charge 200, save. See here image, no, when you go on, when you want to add image, you select size first here and then add image here. Choose file and add image. Because if you don't select the for which size you are adding, because we have kept the option of adding multiple sizes products, that's why we have kept it like that.
Additionally, ma'am, I'd like to also clarify for all the male entrepreneurs here on the training that this platform, for an entrepreneur to register, you have to be a female entrepreneur. For all the male entrepreneurs, you may register yourself as customer and can raise inquiry with any of the entrepreneurs who registered on this platform. I hope that I am able to now answer to Prakash iPhone who had raised this question. Ma'am, there's a query coming in from Faria. Can you please help from beginning? I missed the beginning bit.
Beginning means at least could you understand how to sign up and create login, or even that? You have missed yesterday's session. Did you attend?
Faria, can you please put it on the chat box, please?
Yes, that means you could create your profile. So I will log out and I'll show you again. So once you are here, vsellonline.org, you go to login as an entrepreneur. So you come to this page. So here you enter the username and password. After that, you get the dashboard. In the dashboard, we have product master. In the product master, we are adding brands. Brands we are adding because we want to create our brand. Basically, brand building activity is very important for entrepreneur because people will know you by your brand. So I have created 4 brands here. So whatever brand you want to create here, you select this and add a brand here. Give the title for the brand and say submit. One brand will get added. Okay. After that, you understand how the product master is. Means what all product categories are available. There are available categories like florist, decoration, gift items, handicrafts, home appliances. So all these you can check here. And then there are subcategories like in agriculture, we have fertilizers, seeds. So subcategories also are available. Handicrafts in that, again, home decoration for outdoor, like that. And then you go to sizes. So what all units are available, like bag, bottle, carton, kilogram, square feet, all these units are available. After that, you see there are so many product colors are available. So these are the attributes of the product. So when we create the product, we go to products and say add product, we are getting all the attributes. So already 4-5 products are added. Again, I'll add now fresh cream vanilla cake. I'm giving some kind of code to that because I want to understand from my inventory which all codes I have. So this is of Gift with Love is selling cake. So I'm giving brand as giftwithlove.com. Click Roses is selling roses. So I'm giving brand as clickroses.com.
Sorry, there's a question here for the brand only. Can the brand be different from the company name?
Yeah, actually my company name is different, Web Dreams, and I have given brand as Dipali. That's fine because you have different brands and you can select according to your choice. So I'll select the categories also. Then I'll write the name or description. meta keyword, meta description, you can skip. Sizes of 1 kg, so I'll select the unit here as kilogram, and then I'll select the rate. Okay, and then I'll save some images. Okay, so I go here, I choose the size. You have to select the size. Go to images, select the size, kg, choose file, vanilla, upload. Okay, so I view the products, all products. I have 12 rose bunch, 12 mixed roses bunch, 12 red rose basket, black forest cake, chocolate truffle cake, fresh cream cake. So my e-commerce site with 6 products is ready of 2 different brands. One is clickroses.com flowers, one is giftwithlove.com cakes. And I'm ready to take inquiries from other women entrepreneurs and customers. Is it clear now? I upload a bed sheet. Can you check please, is okay or not? Tazreen, I will check. What name? Okay, I will now browse the portal and search for bedsheet. Yes, Tazreen, I can see your bedsheet, and it's a very beautiful bedsheet.
Yeah, I was about to say that.
Yeah. Is from which country? Okay, so I'll add inquiry for this. To place an inquiry, I need to add my address. It's Dipali Ghotadke, my name, my phone number with the country code. So, PIN code, address, city, all that I will save. So, my address is added and I'll place inquiry for this. So, Tazreen, you must have received the inquiry. In our next session, we have inquiry also. So, first we will complete this work of creating a product profile. So that's very good. I mean, Tazreen can do it, so other people also should be able to do it. All of you, please gear up and start adding products. Anybody else has added the product? You want me to check? I'll check. Okay, Siddhi says that pink salt scrub. Can you check? I will check. Scrub, no, S-C-R-U-B. Okay, pink salt scrub. By who? It is, there are 2-3 scrubs. By Siddhi. I am Siddhi, I am unable to check yours. These are from Darshna, from Sharing and Shubha. Okay, I can check from your name. Search by name, Siddhi.
Sindhi, were you able to register? Just check that if you're being able to.
SIDHI, with this name you have registered? Because I cannot see your Anthropno profile also.
Even Siddhi, I am unmuting you. Can you please speak? Is that Siddhi Daki? Siddhi?
Hi.
Hi.
Sring Wangmo is me.
Sorry?
Siddhi is just a name that I have as in my email. So Sring Wangmo is me. I saw the product. Thank you so much. And sorry for the trouble.
No problem. What's your name you said?
Sring Wangmo.
Can you please spell it?
T-S-H-E-R-I-N-G.
Could you also add that in your profile name, please? Your country name? That would be helpful for us.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Shring is here. And Shring Choden or Wangmo? Okay, Wangmo.
Wangmo, the last one, yes.
Oh, okay. So two have got created from your name. Three, two are there. Okay, yes. So I can see your, that is a very good product. It's good for skin, right? And I will inquire for you also. You have to answer the inquiries.
Okay.
Why you added 35 paisa? Is it by mistake or it is because of discount or something?
It's on mute alone.
No.
Yeah, I think it is a mistake. Sorry. It was 350.
Yeah,
but then I think
you can always edit it.
Okay,
so I have placed inquiry for you also. And then somebody wants me to check the tea. So I'll check your tea. And
just to add to Dipali ma'am, she is raising an inquiry. That means that you will receive an email saying that she has raised an inquiry about your product, and then you can connect with her one-on-one. Also, for everybody's reference, we'll be having an inquiry, how to raise an inquiry sessions tomorrow, and that will be quite interesting for everybody in the terms of networking. Thank you.
Yeah, ginger cordyceps tea by Thinly. I can see that. So here you have written very short description. If you add more details like this tea is good for cold, cough, or it gives you goodness of ginger, which is very good for health as per Ayurveda. Something like this, if you add description, that will help to generate more inquiries. So all products look interesting. Actually, I'm tempted to buy. So I'm inquiring to Thinly also. So three inquiries are placed already. Yeah, but you should also mention whether you will be able to supply to different countries or not. Export from Bhutan to India. That you can do offline with the customer directly. Okay, Ruzina is asking about her profile, and Hak Davi says, I can upload my turmeric powder. Yes, you can upload. Please go ahead so that we can check it, and we'll also market it here. So 75 women present here will be able to check your products, and they are interested, means they can place inquiry for you. So Ruzina, I am checking your, so I go to entrepreneurs, check by name as Ruzina.
Also, okay. Just to add for everybody that you may add a number of products. Don't limit yourself to one or two only. The more number of products that you share, then the greater chances for raising an inquiry is there.
Yeah, Ruzina, yours also two profiles have got created. So I request everybody, you upload a second profile by mistake. Just tell us to remove it Which one is your final? You tell us, we will keep only one. So actually it's very short profile. You have not added all the details. I'm an entrepreneur from Bangladesh, but what exactly you do, products and other stuff, you need to add to get the inquiries. Rituparna says she has uploaded a sari. Could you please check mine? Okay. This is her profile, so very nicely added everything. And she has saris. Okay. So linen jamdani sari has been added. Also, for each product, you can add more images. Okay. It's not that you have to add only one image. You can add more images, for especially for saris. See, you can see how many images she has added. And if you add high resolution image, then the scroll also, zooming is also possible. In the zoom section, it will not look blur. That's a beautiful sari with parrots on it, and I'm tempted to even inquire for this.
Ma'am, there's a question coming in, how to deal after getting an inquiry. Anita requests you to hold on. We have upcoming session, and tomorrow session is focused on how to respond to inquiries and how to raise an inquiry. Thank you.
Actually, as we don't accept payment online here, you have to deal with the customer directly. So you can ask them to pay to your mobile wallet, or like Paytm, Google Pay, or Phone Pay, or directly to your PayPal ID or to your bank, and then you can ship to them. So basically this portal will generate inquiries for you, but you need to take care of the orders on your own offline.
And also for everybody's reference, profiles can be edited. You need to just go on the dashboard. On the top right, there's an option of profile, and you can update your profile there.
Okay, so Hack Devi has given the link. I'll click on the link. And this is the organic turmeric powder. You can also add, right. I think it is showing in this format 0.63 and all, because it is real time converting into rupees. She must have added in round figure only, but in her Cambodian currency. That's why it is automatic, because I'm viewing from India, it is showing me in INR. So the customer, wherever they are present, they will show according to that. So even that time it was showing some 35 paisa and 10 paisa like that. That is because real time it is converting into Indian currency. So here, instead of bottle, if you give in grams, it will be good, because people will like how many grams it is, 250 grams, 300 grams, like that. So
nice. Now there's a query coming in, sold by will show entrepreneur's name only. Can you change it to brand name?
No, here sold by will come from the entrepreneur, because we are promoting entrepreneurs here. So definitely it will come as entrepreneur. It won't come as brand. Brand is this product of Mother Nature is her brand, but it is sold by Hagdev. Let me check chat box. We can't receive payment from PayPal in Pakistan. Okay, that's really sad. So you can receive through mobile wallets or bank transfer, wire transfer. Those are the options for you. So anybody else has done any product addition, any queries till this point? I'm ready to take.
Ma'am, there's a direct message come to me for Upasana Bakuni. Could you check hers as well?
Check what?
Her profile. Upasana, could you put on the chat box, please, what country you're representing, and also change on your profile name? We don't know which country you're representing. Thank you.
Okay, I'll check her profile, Upasana. So, Upasana Bakuni, her photograph is missing. Others is the category, and she's having Fountainhead as her company. Yes, she has some apparels. Okay. That's nice. Yeah, you are all set, Upasana. Yesterday there were many problems, but now you could create your profile also and uploaded product, so you can go on adding further.
Ma'am, there's a query coming in from Teshring. Do I follow the same procedure to add another product?
Yes, I added 6 products and shown. So every time I did the same thing. And there is a bulk upload option available. I will now further go there. I'll close all this. So products, add products in bulk. Somebody was asking. So here I need to upload the document. Okay. And for that, the template has been given, like how you need to create the document. That template you first download here. Okay, so I'll download the template and I will check the format of the template. Okay, so in each product, the product is uploaded in the format of the name, the code, description, price, and sizes. So each product has certain attributes. So depending on the attributes, the product template has been done. So based on those templates, you need to feed all the data. And while feeding the data, you should be careful. You should not enter spaces or commas or colons, because these are in the format of this one database. It is going to go the information. So we have given here some instructions. With this feature, you can publish your products in bulk. You can upload many or all products in one go. For that, you need to prepare a spreadsheet or Excel file, and that will contain all the product details. So the format is given here, and you need to follow the same format. And the file extensions are XLS, XLSS, or .ords. So with this, you need to add product category, subcategory, brand fields, and then you need to add the links for that. And then note that this only creates products with general attributes. And if you need to add price, size, and images and other stuff like other product attributes, you need to click edit product. And again, you need to add the different sizes and attributes for that. So I will check the document now. I have downloaded it. So you can check now what are the attributes are present here. First, you need to give the name of the product, Then you need to give the SKU, that is the stock keeping unit, which is the code which we allot to that product. You need to give the model number, brand ID, product ID, subcategory ID. So for this, you need to refer to the product master. So their IDs are mentioned. So if you go here, you can see in the product master, product category. Here there is category ID. 20 number is for artificial jewelry. 50 number is for gift items. Pet products is 42 number. So number 40 is for others. Like that, you need to select the category number in the Excel format. So here there are columns. Each column has separate ID, separate feature for that product. So product name, SKU, model, brand ID, product ID, then subcategory, description, video URL. If you are adding any video for that, then you need to add the video URL for that. Say youtube.com/video1, something like that. You need to give the video URL. If there are any templates, then say yes or zero for no. So keep this for zero because we are not creating any templates. And you are managing an inventory for that, say no means zero, one means yes, product in stock zero, or no means zero, one means yes. So all these things you go on adding. Product meta keyword, meta description. So once you do that, okay, the name and main items are like name, SKU, model, price, etc. So once you do that, the product will get added. And at a time, you can add, say, 25, 30 products with all the keywords you can create and add it. So any doubt in this? Am I going too fast? Before adding products in bulk, please read the instructions. Yes, I already read the instructions for you. You make it clear by again reading it, and you can ask me message. Suvir, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so any question, you can unmute them.
There's a message from Upasana. I'm not able to click all the sizes available in my garment. It's only taking one size and product uploading.
Yeah, each product only one size. Upasana, please share your number. So I will ask the technical team to call you and explain you how to add multiple sizes.
Additionally, ma'am, there was a question coming in from Finlay. What category should I use for quinoa? The team has responded grocery.
Yeah, that's right.
Does anyone have any more questions? The floor is open so that then we can proceed for the next session.
We'll have 5 minutes break.
Yes, ma'am. We have a 5 minutes. The floor is open. If anybody has any questions, they can take it up.
So bulk upload, what you do is you can able to do it only with trial and error. You'll understand once you add 5 products here. And then you save that document and then go here, add products in bulk, and then upload the document. Choose the file. We'll choose the file here. Say I've created one Excel file and then upload it. Once you upload that, all the products will get uploaded in bulk. You need not add one by one. If you have many products in hundreds, then you better go for bulk upload. Okay, so with that, we complete the add product, bulk upload product, add category, add master, everything we have completed. regarding services, we'll start the next session in next 5 minutes. So I'll be back in 5 minutes. Meanwhile, if you have any question, please type it in the chat box. Thank you.
In the meantime, if anybody has any questions, feel free to share with us with regard to products. Once this, we'll start with the next session in 5 minutes on creating services catalog and uploading profiles. Till now, we were doing it for products, so the next session focuses on the services. The floor is open. If anybody has any questions, feel free to share, please. Deepthi, there's an option which says upload products in bulk. There you'll find this, add products in bulk. Under the products, the second line item which says add products in bulk. Does anyone have any other questions? In the meantime, I'm also sharing the our social media accounts of Facebook group, Facebook page, Twitter, and on VSEL Online. I hope everybody's joined the Facebook groups and the Instagram accounts. These groups are really interactive. So if anybody, for all of you looking for social networking among all the other fellow participants, feel free to join this page. And yesterday also we had shared the group details, and I hope everybody, whoever is not joined yet, please join. Also, the third thing, I'd like to take this opportunity to let everybody know, tomorrow we have a session on the networking, and where everybody will get an option to do an exhibition about the products and services. You can get your products with you in the room, and then you can show it to us, or while where everybody would get a minute or so to talk about the products, about the stories. If anybody wants to share the stories with us on the WhatsApp group, feel free to share your small videos with us, and we would love to share them tomorrow in the session and also on a social media platform. If you want to share any quotes, any how these trainings are being helpful for you, feel free to share on the WhatsApp group. Whoever has not shared your details on the yet with us, you can put it in the chat box. We've created the WhatsApp group, and I'm assuming most of you have been added. If anybody has not been added yet, share your number with us. Deepthi, send me your send us on the chat box. My colleagues are there creating the WhatsApp group. Okay. Can you share that from the chat box with my colleagues on VSEL Online team, please? And also, everybody, tomorrow, don't forget to bring on your products and services. We'll be sharing with the details with everybody. We'll have a platform for sharing it with your fellow participants. So don't forget to exhibit your products and services. It's a good option for you to do networking with all the participants from various countries present here. Deepthi, okay, one second. I'll share it with the team. One moment. We are sharing the Facebook group details link again with everybody. Those who have not joined, you can take it up. Mr. Ali, we had spoken yesterday about SEO, and we'll also be sharing our presentation with everybody. The links will be shared with everyone, and you can take a look from there. Additionally, we also have an e-learning course. I'll request everybody to please register on that e-learning course. That will also give you four more details about SEO, SEM, and further various other the intricate details about e-commerce and digital marketing. It's a free online e-learning course. I'll request everyone to please register, and it's a certified course. So once you do that, you will get a certified course by certification from EIF and UNSCAP. Deepti, my team will add you by the end of the session. And also, Deepti, I believe you did the certification yesterday. It will be really great. I will give if you were there, and I would want you to show the certificate to everybody so that that motivates everyone to show this. I am unmuting you, Deepti, and you can also show your video and show the certificate to everybody. Or you share the certificate with me, and then I'll share it with all the colleagues here.
Hi, Suvira. Can I share my screen?
I'm not too sure if you would have that option. Why don't you share it with me if possible?
I'm sorry, I didn't get you. Can you just repeat?
I am sharing my email address with you, so you could share it with me on that, and I'll put it up for everyone to see.
Yeah, sure. I will share it with you on my email in India.
Yeah. Those asking about the link for the e-learning course, one moment, I'll share that link with everybody.
And Suvira, my partner Deepshika, she's also there in this with me on this training. She also completed her program online thing yesterday, and she also got the certificate. So maybe she can also send you the same. I'm just
any one of you. I mean, I just want to show it with everybody that this is where it is.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. So this is the link I've shared with everybody. That's the link. On that link, if you go, there's an icon for e-learning course. Click on that icon and you can see. There's an e-learning course.
Okay, so there was one question like length and height. Length,
yes,
is,
ma'am.
If you have seen rectangle, the length is the horizontal portion of it, and vertically what we see is the height. So you can set it in the product option. So add product we have, no? There even size and price is there. There we have length and height. So you can add it there. Hope it clears your doubt. And I think 21 products are uploaded, including mine 6. So at least another 15 people or 15 products have been uploaded. So some of you can do it, means everybody can do it. So you can try, and there is a WhatsApp number given of our vclonline.org. So you can always call us, and you can clear your doubts. We'll give you complete support through over phone call also. Okay, so if you all
can we begin with the next session then, if everybody
is
here?
Yeah. So okay. Now we are done with the products. So we'll go for services.
The session would be creating services catalog and uploading your profile as an entrepreneur on the VSL online, but more focus on services this time. Ma'am, go ahead.
Yeah. So before going ahead, Faria Siddiqui is telling me to check her pictures. So, I will just check. So she has added some saris. Yeah, I can see your sari. Okay, that's nice, and even the rate is quite reasonable. Okay, what you can do is you can add more colors also. Okay, so your product is there for you.
Ma'am, there's a question coming in. Can I change my page link?
Page link you cannot change. It is generated by the system, so you cannot change it. Okay, so I'll go to services. So like how it is for product master, like that we have services master also. So we have categories. These are categories for our reference, like beauty and wellness, business opportunities, communication, information technology, marketing. So all these categories we have created. If any category is not found, it will be under other services. So you can select as other. And that ID for that is category number 15 is other services. So I will go to the subcategory. In information technology, we have web designing. In information technology, a mobile app. Similarly, in beauty and wellness, we have personal fitness. So such categories we have created and kept. And if any category is missing, you please request us, we'll create it. After checking services category and services subcategory, I will go to the services section and then go to add service. Okay. So now my service is stage decoration. And the main category is, now I'm not finding my any category, beauty and wellness, decoration or something. Event management is my category. It is not there. So what I'll do is other services. Image, now I will just download something from Google just for your reference. Okay, so choose file. And then we do stage decoration for various occasions like wedding, parties, etc. at reasonable cost. Okay, so this is our service. I'll submit it. So my service is added here. So you can check here. So now I'll go to my profile, entrepreneur, search by name Dipali. In front of Dipali, I have other services. So this is my stage decoration is my service which I offer. And the description has come here. So anybody wants to inquire, they can inquire. Okay, so this is the way to add the services. It's very simple. Go to services, click on add service. You can add title, category, image, and description. That's it. And your gift packing. Your service will be added without any mistake. So
ma'am, I have got two questions from two participants asking. If you could explain, once you're done with the process of uploading, adding products, once you've added your products and services, how do you check? Because I've got two messages from two entrepreneurs, the same question. How do we check that we've uploaded successfully?
Yeah. I'll just finish this listing. See, when you go to the products, add product you do, later on here there is option of view products and you can select all products. So what all products you added, like 12 rose bunch, 12 mixed rose bunch, cakes, everything is listed here. This is at the entrepreneur dashboard. In the main site, if you want to check, you have to go here again, vsellonline.org. And then here you have to search for your product. So my product, I can search here, cake. I can search and I can see that all these people have listed Dipali Ghotadke Black Forest Cake is listed here. Dipali Ghotadke Chocolate Truffle Cake is listed here. Fresh Cream Vanilla Cake is listed here. So you can either search by product or you can search by entrepreneur. You can search by your name. So your name, you can search name Dipali, I'm searching. So I will get my listing here, profile here. And then I will select like what all in flower basket, I have flower basket. Go back, I will check in others, I have cakes, then I have flowers, then I have services also. So my services are also listed here. My services are stage decoration and gift packing. So both are listed here.
Ma'am, we have another question coming in which has directly come to me is, what category does apparel, home decor and handmade accessories fit into?
We already have home decor and apparel, both are the separate categories are available, and also handicraft is one of the category you can select for your handmade products. We have those categories, you can check here. So product master and product category. So we have home decor, home appliances, home decor is not there, okay. Only decoration is there. In decoration, you can select. And also, we can, you just suggest like those people who are unable to find their category, please select one by one category here. We'll go on adding right now. Admin, so please add decor. Admin.
You can, either you may raise your hand or you can put it on the chat box.
Yeah. So home decor we'll add now. Apparel is already there, textile and apparel. So you can select that, or even women apparel is there in women's fashion.
Ma'am, just check if home decor might also get covered under your decoration. So
yeah,
just check decoration, on the categories once.
Decoration you can select. In decoration we have stage decoration, car decoration, interior decoration. So you can select as interior decoration, your category.
We have a question coming in. Can I select multiple categories?
For one product? No. For one product, you have to select the most appropriate single category.
Okay, Deepti has raised a hand. Would you want to take the question now, ma'am? Or would you want to take it after you close with your services?
No, we can take it now.
Okay. Deepti, you may go ahead, please.
Hi, Dipali. I have a question that, let's say if we have two brands, you know, one is for handicrafts and handmade products and everything. And the second one is for travel. So one comes under products and one comes under services. So should I register both of them with different IDs, or I can, you know, upload my things with the same ID in different sections? How does it work?
With the same ID only I have created now. If you see, I'm Dipali and I have both services also and products also. Okay. So products, I have flowers, cakes and flower basket. Services, I have these other services like decoration and gift and packaging.
So, okay. The travel thing comes under services, right? The travel, yes, comes under services.
Yeah.
Travel. So I can do it with the same ID.
Yes, yes.
Okay. And I have uploaded one of my product. Can you just see, and the profile also? Can you just see if I have done it correctly or need some corrections?
Okay. Oh, Deepti, right?
Yes, Deepti. It's DEEPTI.
Okay. Name selections. Okay, nice. I recommend everybody to write at least this much description about you, about your story. That will increase your chances of getting more orders. So your profile looks very good. And then you have products like home decoration. Okay.
Everything. I mean, like for better living, everything for better living comes underneath. That I will try and explain tomorrow in a little quick manner when we have a one-to-one session.
Yeah, you can do that. So even you have very beautiful product like pottery and all. So you please go on adding it. And I'm sure by tomorrow, if you add, you'll get more inquiries in tomorrow's session also. People are seeing the site now more often. So there are better chances of getting more inquiries.
Okay. So this was just a trial thing. So I just wanted to have the idea.
No, this is fair enough. So you can add further things also.
Sure. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks. Tazima is asking, can I log in now? Yes, you can log in because we already started with listing of services. And women fashion, you can select. Yes, Zaid. Or you can select also apparel and textiles. Okay, so actually we are done with adding services. It's very simple. So it takes just one single form to add service. Here you select the title, category, choose the image for it, write the service description for it, and then you just submit it. Your product and service, your service will get saved. So now we are open to questions only because I want you all to try it. Then only you will get questions. If you don't try, you will not get any questions.
Okay, ma'am, just when you said questions, the first question came in from Sinhan. I tried to add product picture, but I can't do it. Would you want me to unmute her or would you want to resolve it like that?
See, many people are making this mistake that when you add product, I will again show it one by one. Okay, I will add now one product. I'll add as... Now, what cake is remaining? Pineapple cake. So I have added the name and the category and all. Size I'm adding as 1 kg, kilogram, and then price. Say 1200 rupees, 10% discount, 200 rupees. Save. Here, when you add images, no, first you select the size here. Many people are not doing that. That's why their product is not getting added. Select the size, which you have set it here, no, in the second tab. This size you have to select while adding the image. So I'll add kg as image size and then choose file. Before that, I need to save some of the pineapple cake. So once you select the size here, you need to select the size here and then choose the file in format of JPG. So because image format is generally JPG or PNG, and upload. So this image will appear here. Now I'm sure you must be able to upload the image. Okay, that's nice, Zara Roya, that you could apply, you could upload some of the images. I'll check. So Simhang, can you upload now? You want to try now? You can view your products here.
Ma'am, there's a question coming on the shipping cost. I do not know how to estimate the shipping cost.
How to?
How do I estimate the shipping cost?
Yeah, if you don't know, you need to check with your local post office or courier company. And depending on, you can mention there like up to 50 kilometers or up to or interstate or intrastate, like that. Shipping charges you can mention. So suppose you are delivering only in your state, you can charge a fixed shipping charge for 1 kg product. For 2 kg, it is double, something like that. You need to check with your courier company first. Then only you'll be able to do it. Shipping charges depends on the distance and the weight. So if the distance is more, it will be more. If the weight is more, the cost will be more. So it depends on your atom size. Okay, so now you could, Simhan, can you try now? And you can see if you can upload the images, because other people like Roya and all are uploading, so I'm sure it is not that difficult. So Deepshikha is writing here, I have my new startup only 2 months old. And I am delivering only in Delhi NCR now. So still, can I add our products? Yes, you can add. You may get orders from Delhi NCR only. So you can add, and which will be helpful for you also to share your profile. Suppose I want to share my profile with somebody, I can just go to the URL, copy that, go to my WhatsApp and share it. So suppose I am sharing with somebody. I'll go here and I'll paste that URL. So that will give my profile. Once I click that link, my profile will be open. So this will be helpful to send your profile also to other people, like your catalog, your brochure, you'll be able to send it.
Ma'am, there's a query again from Upasana. Do I need to upload the same product 3 times for different sizes?
No, you can. Now I will show you that. So product master, products, add product. So suppose I have Black Forest cake, BF001, model round cake, brand gift with love, main category is food and processed food, and subcategory is others. So Black Forest cake.
200, sorry, 1200, 100, save.
So here you can go on adding size, 2 kg. Save. So you can check here, you are getting, see, one product only, different sizes and different weight. Okay, actually weight I should have given, so I'll edit and give the weight as 2 kg. Save. Here also I will give as 1 kg. I did reverse, I think. So you can see that for one product only you had a different weights, 1 kg weight, 2 kg weight, like that.
Ma'am, the question coming in from Anita. This website is available in all the countries. Anyone can order from any country. And second question is, which is the best courier option?
In India, best courier is Indian Post. That is the Speed Post. And also internationally, there are Blue Dart, FedEx, which are very popular. Gati for high, heavy freights. So it depends on your country. You can inquire, you can check with your local businesses, which is the best and reliable service in your country. But post office, post service is very good. So it depends on your country. As far as my e-commerce activity is concerned, I always use Indian Post.
Also, ma'am, there's a question asking, how I'm being unable to change my update in my profile.
You can update. See, you go here. In the dashboard right hand corner, profile and update. So here you can do changes what you want and update. So what error you are getting, or could you open this particular page or no? Okay, so here I have not yet added my Facebook profile, so I'll add it.
Deepthi, I'll request you to put it in the chat box, please. Thank you.
Yes, I could do it. I had forgotten to add the Facebook link. I have added it now. Photo is already there. If you want to update your firm details, you can update your website, email. Contact number. So it is updating. Here also we have meta tags. Each product we have meta tags, and also for the main profile we have meta tags. So on those we are going to get found in Google. So it is important to add these meta keywords and meta description. Hello, if we don't know shipping charge, what is your suggestion? You can add the standard charges, like now I added 100 rupees. Later on, you can always tell them to pay more or less, depending on the location. Actually, Veera, I have done with the explanation. So now, as it is a practical and one-to-one interactive session, I'm expecting them to ask me questions and also undergo the process of adding the profile and adding the products and services. So if you wish, we can start a little early the next session, maybe 2:45.
Okay, let's do it, ma'am. Once we go closer to the session, we'll take a call. In the meantime, I have a few hands raised, so I'll just take the question one by one. Okay, Deepthi, I'll unmute you. Deepthi, you may go ahead, please.
Sure. Dipali, the profile you checked of mine recently, I just wanted to add one line in the existing paragraph, but it is showing update, and update is asking me all other details except not the same paragraphs. I'm unable to edit the same paragraph which I have written earlier.
What you do is go to update.
Okay.
So this is the para, your personal profile.
Okay.
Right? So you just cut it, go to Word and paste it there.
Okay.
And edit it.
Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, then again select it.
Okay.
Copy it.
And paste it there. So basically, I cannot edit there, but I can.
No, you can edit. You can edit here also. See, I'm adding here also.
Okay.
But you couldn't add, no? So I told you easier way.
Okay. Sure.
You can add here also.
Sure. Thank you.
See, I have added here. It is updated. See, those two lines got added.
Yes. Sure. Thank you.
Yeah, you are welcome. Yeah, next please.
Is there anyone else who would want to ask? So just to be curious enough, ma'am, would the technical team be able to tell how many accounts have been created between yesterday and today?
Yeah, admin and support.
We have 70 participants, so I'm assuming at least in the range of 40-50 should have been created. I'll once again encourage everybody to please register on this platform. This would act as a very good training platform for you before you go on to the major big giants like Amazon, Flipkart, because in order to be able to upload products there, you need to get a hands-on here on this platform and be able to run on this platform successfully. There's a question coming in, ma'am, from Zayab. I am dealing in modest fashion like abaya and hijab. What category should I select?
No, we already explained her, no? Like she can select women fashion or women or textile and apparel.
There's a question coming in, ma'am. Can I add homestay in services?
Yes, you can add. It is more like a lodging service only, so you can add it. Your website platform is similar to Amazon, right? Yes, it is similar. It's a multi-vendor portal, but it doesn't provide you facility to sell online. I mean to do the transaction of payment online. So, and Amazon is much more complicated because it has too many features, and if you see in the control panel, there are many options available. We have made it very, very simple so that even grassroots level and people who are having challenge to deal with the e-commerce and technology should be able to learn it and should be able to upload it.
Is there anyone else who would want to ask any questions that are coming across your mind? Would you also want to show the Facebook page of ESOL Online, ma'am, to everybody so that more and more people can join that page?
Yes, we can do that. So I think some just now link has been posted here. We have Facebook group also, and we have Facebook page also. This is our Facebook page, vclonline.org. So here we go on giving you information about digital marketing, e-commerce, what is hashtag is our latest post. Then also we go on posting about entrepreneur of the month, like Sujata Chatterjee. So here we are promoting entrepreneurs also, and then promoting and giving information about e-commerce. So this post is about payment gateway. E-commerce is basically dependent on various payment gateways, that is credit card, debit card, net banking. So these all facilities are available through payment gateway. So how they work and all that, one post is given. So this is the Facebook page, and you can join the group so that if you want to post anything and promote your product, you can put the postings here of your products or services. So this is the group, and then here we have posts like from Farihana. She has posted some handicraft items, needle art and craft. Then Sharmin Akhtar Khan has put some bed sheets and all. So these things are available, and sarees have been posted by Silk and Silk, Rati. So people are seeing the post, liking it and inquiring it. So that is possible through even our Facebook group. So I invite you all to join this group. Right now, go there by clicking the icon, clicking the link given in the chat box. Again, I will give the link if you want. So, anybody could add services? I would like to check it. Can I create multiple account? I create an account in June, but I deleted my Facebook page and create a new. Now what will I do? So Tamanna, you are asking about Facebook account or what exactly? Or account on VSL Online? Okay, that's nice, Gani. You added the services. I'll check it. You can create multiple accounts even in Facebook. You can create multiple accounts at vclonline.org also. But if you have same product and same service, I recommend you to create only one account. Okay, there are now 6 new services listed, including ours. And how many new entrepreneurs are there since yesterday? Yesterday around 15-20 had registered. I don't know about the numbers today.
I think 31 is the count that
okay.
Our colleagues shared with me.
Okay, that's good. I mean, some people are taking some time to get the documents and all, maybe. If also, has a question, you can.
Yes, if also Upasana could, 1 second, let me unmute you. Upasana, you can go ahead.
Yeah, thank you, Savira. I want to find out if I need to upload, let's say, more than 50 or 200 garments. So do you suggest I should go with that template thing or I should do it manually? Because they'll be having different sizes as well.
Better you go with the template thing. You can upload
it. When I open the template, so it obviously gave different, kind of headings. So do I need to change it according to my requirement?
No, headings you can't change.
As in it said quantity and the length, yeah. Breadth, width. I mean, that is not needed in garments, right?
So, yeah, it's not needed. Those things which are not related, you can leave it blank.
Okay, but I could see that when I was editing, I could even edit that.
Yeah. No, you should not edit that. One. You should do from second row itself, you are going to add your content. Don't edit the fields. Fields should be kept fixed.
Yeah, but with garments, it was not going at all.
What error you are getting?
Price SKU, that was going, price discount. And I still don't know because when we talk about the shipping charges, I don't know who will be ordering from where. So we can't even customize. I was trying to write depending on, where it is ordered from.
Because it's not real time, no? It is not going to have online order and payment and shipping calculation. That's right. Why that field is given just to give the range or maybe understanding.
Yeah, so, could it be added somewhere that shipping charges would be extra? That's it.
Yeah. You can add in your product information. Right. There are some, information is there. No, there you can add that shipping charge will be extra.
Okay. And if you see the template, it is not showing me the kind of, it is not favoring my kind of product. So what do we do?
No, it will be suitable for everybody. This is the template, no? So you add the product name, the SKU, model, brand ID, category, subcategory, description. That much only you go on adding.
Okay.
Later on, whichever you want, you can edit it.
I'm just trying to open and see.
Yeah.
In case I need to ask you anything, I could have just asked. Because product size, of course, okay, size will be there. Quantity.
Quantity is given.
I don't need to mention a quantity here, right? If I'm, let's say, for example, if I'm saying I'm putting that jacket and a dress. So the length.
That's for your reference, actually, because you will understand how many orders to take if you have quantity written there in stock or not.
Yeah, so this if I write my stock, but this need not be shared in the website, right?
No, it will be in dashboard only. Dashboard, all content is not shared in the website. Dashboard is mainly for entrepreneur.
Okay, so this template would actually get uploaded to my dashboard. It will not be shown to the people who will be checking my profile or my...
It will be product. Shown in the form of products.
Okay. So obviously that length, width, height will not work for me. Weight will not work for me.
Of course, no. That all will not be shown.
Okay. And I saw you putting the picture or the link, website link. So here it doesn't show anywhere where I can upload my pic on the template.
Picture of what?
Did you upload your cakes pic on the template?
No. I uploaded it individually. Okay, you can adding it, and images you can add individually.
Okay, so when I'm adding individually, how is that relating to this template?
Through the template, once all the products are added, no? Then you go on editing it one by one and adding the images.
Okay, so in any case, I will have to upload the pic the way we had uploaded my first product.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Yeah, welcome.
Thank you so much, Upasana. Okay, so Now, will anybody else wants anything to be checked or anyone wants any queries to be resolved? We have another 5 minutes before we start the next session. There was a query from, I think I missed this, from somebody was asking for you to check their account. Finlay Yangsam, could you check mine, please?
What to check her login service?
Finlay, could you tell us what you want us to check? Finlay Yangsam?
I think about her service. Yeah, she has given travel and tourism, farmhouse. Yeah.
Finlay, try adding some relevant image also. That will really help us for anybody who's exploring this option. Is there anyone else who'd want to ask anything? That could be anything for VSEL Online, how to register, what is the link, or how do you register as an entrepreneur, upload your products, not being able to upload products or services, any information about a profile, anything about the IMG document, any doubt anyone is facing. We have the last 5 minutes before we move on to the next session. Feel free to put it on the chat box, or you can even raise your hand. Also, I'll request the technical team to please put in the email addresses also for everybody's reference. Dipali ma'am, there's a question coming in from Gyani. Can I upload two or more photos to the services?
Yeah, you can add portfolio. So here, in the services, add service. View services, all services, we have portfolio here. So you can add portfolio. So it is like stage decoration. So this way you can add your portfolio.
Okay, there's a question coming in for presentation slides, and yes, we will be sharing the presentation slides. The link will be shared with all the participants, and you can download the presentation slides. You would have to give us time till tomorrow and day after for the session to end, and then we'll do it. Once again, I'll just share with for everyone's knowledge that all these slides will be shared with you. And tomorrow we have an inquiry generation session. So I hope everybody is not over by probably by today evening, you're able to upload about your products and services so that tomorrow when you do the live hands-on session on inquiry generation, everybody can do that. And besides that, our team has shared the VSEL Online and the e-learning link also for everyone to refer to. And the team has also shared my email address and VSEL Online email address also. So, and everybody's been added to the WhatsApp group also, but I think by today evening will be done. In case anyone has not shared the contact details, feel free to add in the chat box and we'll do it. I think that's it from my end, Dipali ma'am. Is there anything you want to add before you close your session and then we can move to the next session?
Yeah, Tazima wanted me to check her profile and I can see her profile. So I think it is good, and even she has given website. So that's a very smart way, like you give your website also, so all the details will be available there. Oh, very beautiful artwork done here. Nice. From Bangladesh. Okay, so thank you. And if any questions, we have shared our email IDs, info@vclonline.org and contact@vclonline.org. You can contact us. Also, our phone number is there. You can do a WhatsApp call because you'll be internationally placed. And also, you can join our Facebook group. So this is our Facebook group. And there are so many women already part of the network, more than 250. Who are interacting with each other and also placing their orders and inquiries there. And I wish you all the best to create the create your portfolio in terms of products and services. And I hope it will generate more and more inquiries for you. So thank you. Thanks, Suvira, for all your support and questions during the session.
So, thank you so much, Dipali ma'am. You may stop sharing the screen now. Thank you so much, Dipali ma'am. And now we'll move on to the next session, Assessment of Gender Digital Divide by Dr. Radhika Kumar, Advisor, Infrastructure Policy, Trade, Oceans, Nature Resources Directorate, Commonwealth Secretariat, London. Radhika, you have the floor. Radhika, can you unmute?
Sorry. Hi, everyone. Let me just share my screen and then we can start.
Yes.
Okay. Let me just.
Radhika, would you mind going on the presentation mode, please? Yeah.
Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. My name is Radhika. I've already been introduced. First of all, I must thank Dr. Rajan for inviting me to just briefly present on what we are doing in terms of the gender digital divide in terms of digital infrastructure in the Commonwealth. And also, but before I start, I know this is more a presentation mode, but I also appreciate the sessions that happened yesterday and today on the VCL online. It's really good. And I think it is something which can be scaled up also for women in other regions as well. So just wanted to, you know, put on record this acknowledgement. So let me just, sorry, I'm having some difficulties. Are you able to see my slides when I scroll? Oh yeah, okay, hold on. Yeah, so basically the outline of my presentation is that I will be sharing with all of you a brief background on the physical connectivity cluster of the Commonwealth. And then I will touch a little bit of why infrastructure development is important and how it links to the digital side of things, and also touch a bit on the gender digital divide that exists across the Commonwealth countries in relation to Southeast Asia as well. I will show a little bit of analysis and then provide some concluding remarks. With this, I also will be sharing with you a course which is open to everyone to actually take, and we just launched it last week. It is on digital infrastructure and digital divide in the Commonwealth. And also I've shared a video with Suvira, which she can share later with all of you who are interested. Maybe and this might complement the VCL online. Is just teaching those of you who might be interested to create your own business website in 30 minutes. Just something practical rather than just presenting slides today. So with this, just a bit of a background, the Commonwealth Secretariat convened the Commonwealth Heads of Ministers meeting in 2018. And then that was when the Commonwealth Heads of Governments endorsed the Commonwealth Connectivity Agenda. Now, just to mention that the Commonwealth Secretariat has got 54 member countries, and it includes countries from Southeast Asia as well, including countries such as India, Bangladesh, also we have Maldives and others. So what happened was that once the connectivity agenda was operationalized, we have then formed different clusters. So the physical connectivity cluster, which is led by the Gambia, is focusing work on digital infrastructure and digital divide. And we have an aspect of women and youth empowerment in that as well. So members had developed the principles on sustainable investment in digital infrastructure, which has got six core principles. On this slide, basically, it's just simply trying to show why infrastructure, including digital infrastructure, is important in the economies of countries. And having said that, when we are talking about digital infrastructure, we are talking about the hard infrastructure, but we are also talking about the soft infrastructure, which are the people's skills. So if a country has good infrastructure, of course, it will enable better development, economic growth, trade and investment. We also note that while this is positive, there is also major digital divide that exists in relation to quality, access, and affordability of infrastructure, and mostly affecting the gender side of things, including women. We also know that the demand for infrastructure is likely to increase because of the increase in population, urbanization, health and safety concerns, and international trade with the rise of digital technology as well. The Commonwealth also conducted a COVID-19 survey on the economic response. And our survey actually found both that digital infrastructure is important and will be a key enabler in the economic recovery of countries. So infrastructure, as mentioned, is part of capital investment. It will help businesses to generate productive capacity and reduce transaction costs. And the WeSell Online is an example. It's a platform as a service, which is a digital infrastructure, and it is now currently assisting all of you to actually engage in business. And also, if I'm talking about soft infrastructure, that is building the capacity of people, be it from the first mile of skills in the digital infrastructure ecosystem or the last mile, such as entrepreneurs and women. Once the skills are developed, of course, the productivity of the country will increase. Also, infrastructure is important for supply chain resilience as well, and also improving trade facilitation. And countries, studies have also shown that countries that have got quality infrastructure are likely to attract more foreign direct investment. On this slide, I'm just trying to give a synergy between the digital infrastructure ecosystem. We have got the first mile, which is basically connecting the physical infrastructure into the digital infrastructure. So this is basically what we term as infrastructure as a service. Mostly we can say it's data centers. Then we have the middle layer, which we call platform as service. Then the final layer is where we have got applications and which links to the last mile users. So today, basically, through this WeSell Online, it is a platform. And once you guys are linking it with apps, you are reaching the customers, which is the last mile. But then what in the Commonwealth we are looking at, the entire digital infrastructure ecosystem, from linking the first mile to the last mile. And underpinning this, we also realize that soft infrastructure, which is the skills, the capacity of individuals, are also important. It is changing throughout the infrastructure ecosystem. And therefore, we are trying to work with the countries to empower them and also to improve these digital skills. So on this slide, basically, I've got some examples of digital infrastructure, what I basically explained. But for like MSMEs, the most important in terms of the digital landscape currently is where they are linking to the platforms and also using different softwares to basically deliver their service. And because these platform as a service and software as a service, these two layers of the digital infrastructure basically has some costs, but it is relatively low compared to if a business has to develop its own entire infrastructure. So again, this platform which of we sell online provides you with that kind of benefit where you don't really have to develop a platform yourselves, but with practice, you people have basically, you know, learned how to upload your products and then just reach the users in the or customers in the last mile. And of course, as mentioned, underpinning these soft infrastructure skills, that is the education and training, is also crucial. Now I'm going to just give you some snapshots of the depth of the gender digital divide that exists. So it is present in the all the regions of the country and also globally, and why we are currently focusing on this. So one of the reports of the World Economic Forum actually showed that in terms of the gender global gap, it will now take about 135 years to close the gender gap worldwide. And then there are different indices for measuring the global gender trends. And it shows that in terms of political empowerment, it will take 145 years to attain. And in terms of the economic participation of women, meaning in business, in the economy, it will take 267 years to close. And this is because gender divide was already in existence pre-COVID, but then with COVID-19, we have got major disruptions that has happened in the market and also with automation and digitalization. So we at the Commonwealth have also done this analysis in terms of the digital gender divide. And we looked at different factors across the 54 Commonwealth countries in terms of the difference in schooling between male and female, which we call gender parity. And then the same in terms of the income levels between male and female, the bank account ownership, the use of social media, and also in terms of the mobile ownership. So in relation to the Asian region, we've seen that the results are mixed. In terms of gender parity in schooling, there are certain countries such as Brunei, Darussalam, that have a score of 100. India, Pakistan, and Bangladesh have scores of 43, 44, and 77, which kind of shows that if we are really to integrate women and girls in the digital economy, we need to improve this in terms of providing better access to education and schooling. And then also in terms of account ownership, the results are also very different. Countries such as Maldives, India, Malaysia, Singapore, and Sri Lanka, they are performing better, meaning women are able to open bank accounts more easily and access to finance. But countries such as Pakistan need further improvement in this area. And then in terms of income inequality, Singapore has got the highest. It is actually performing well in with a score of 80, but then there are other countries that need to actually reduce the income gap between males and females. And some of these countries are Maldives, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and Pakistan. Then also in terms of gender gap in social media usage, that is access to the social media between males and females, the Asian countries of Malaysia, Singapore, Maldives are performing better, while though countries in Pakistan, India, and Bangladesh and Sri Lanka do give access, but then this access can be further enhanced because their score is low. And why this is important is, as you've seen in terms of accessing the social media platform, how important it is for women to then go online and do business. And in terms of mobile device ownership, the same is true. Singapore ranks the highest, whereas countries in the South Asia region need to further empower women and also provide them with further mobile device access in relation to maybe mobile phones, smartphones to do business. So Pakistan, Bangladesh, and India in this case have scores below 34, and they need to perhaps increase in this area as well. So this was in relation to the Asian context, but in the Commonwealth, as I've mentioned, we have got different regions. In the context of Europe, we have three countries: Cyprus, United Kingdom, and Malta. All these three countries are basically performing better when it comes to gender parity in schooling and even in account ownership, social media use, and also mobile device ownership. However, in terms of income inequality, the income gaps between male and female, of course, these countries also need to improve in this area, because countries such as UK and Malta have scores of 53, which means it's low, it can still be increased. So having said that, one of the things is very apparent that the gender gap or the gender digital divide issues, though it is some economists say that it is more for the developing countries or LDCs. It is true, but also it is affecting the developed countries as well. So in a nutshell, it is a issue or it is a challenge that needs to be addressed globally. And also in relation to the African context, the results are even more mixed. In terms of gender parity in schooling, there are certain countries that are performing better, such as South Africa, Botswana, Mauritius, Namibia, and Lesotho. But then there are certain countries such as Mozambique and Cameroon that have low scores of 39 and 48 respectively. And they need to basically empower young girls at an early age in order for them to then engage in the digital economy. Then in terms of account ownership, again, there are certain countries in the African region that are performing better, such as Lesotho, Namibia, South Africa, Mauritius. But then there are other countries, such as the Gambia and others that are not performing that well. Again, income inequality seems to be something of an issue across all the regions. And the income gap is wider than other variables. In terms of African region, also the scores for some countries are between 70 to 84, such as Zambia, Nigeria, Kenya, Rwanda, Mozambique, whereas for some countries it is a little bit better. Now, in terms of gender gap in social media, again, this is important, as previously mentioned, because this is the last mile connection which connects the entrepreneurs of MSMEs, women in business, to the customers. But also in the African context, the scores are quite low, meaning that there's a huge gap between ownership of or access to social media between males and females. So countries such as Gambia, Rwanda, Malawi, Ghana, Mozambique, Sierra Leone, Nigeria, and Uganda have scores between 17 to 48. And again, in terms of mobile device ownership, again, some countries are performing well, such as Kenya, Eswatini, Ghana, Namibia, which have scores of 80, means they give more access. But countries such as Malawi, Zambia, Gambia, Mozambique, Sierra Leone, Rwanda, they have scores from 7 to 54. Then if we look at the Caribbean and Americas region, though the region, which comprises of a small island states, are performing well in terms of schooling with scores of 100, but then there are certain areas where they also need further improvements. And this include in terms of income inequality, they need to close those gaps, and also in relation to account ownership and mobile device ownership. Now, in the Pacific context, the region which I come from, basically, again, the gender parity figures are different for different variables. So in relation to gender parity in schooling, though for all the countries, Vanuatu, Solomon Islands, New Zealand, Samoa, Tonga, Fiji, and Australia, the scores are above 83. However, for countries such as Papua New Guinea, the scores are low, which is at 63. So this region actually needs to improve its gender parity in schooling. And also in terms of account ownership, though some countries have performed better, but there are certain countries such as Papua New Guinea and Vanuatu that need improvement in this area. Again, we have seen that the income gap is also widened in the Pacific region as well, with PNG having a score of 78, whereas countries such as Fiji, Samoa have scores of 44, 46, and 48 respectively. In relation to also access to social media, though there's a good access given to male and female in relation to the use of social media, but however, there are still certain countries such as Papua New Guinea in the region that needs to increase this access. And also in relation to mobile device ownership, though the region is performing well, but then there are certain countries such as Tonga that have lower scores. Now it is quite important to understand this, because it ultimately affects MSMEs and also businesses as a whole. Because if you are trying to trade in other regions, you would want to know how well their digital infrastructure is or their digital capability is for you to actually trade. Then I've done a bit of a research in the South Asia context as well. And from this graph, what it is trying to show is basically the percentage of female population to the male population. So if you see on this graph, almost all the countries in the South Asia region, including Afghanistan, Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, Turkey, Iran, all the countries have female population, which is close to 50% of the total population. Now, this speaks volume, because what it is actually saying is that in future, you know, in the labor force, the women will be even more critical or important. Not just here we are empowering women to get online and do business and also, you know, have good standards of living, but more so, if I'm looking at the entire economic growth model, then women are a major part of the labor force, meaning they will be the contributors, a major contributor to their countries. And because South Asia region is growing at such a rapid rate, this is very important for policymakers to understand, and even businesses to understand, and also the wider stakeholders, because we need to now more than ever ensure that we have inclusive policies in place. So this is basically in terms of the global gender gap and the rankings of South Asia. So there's regional ranking and there's global ranking. So in terms of the regional ranking, Bangladesh ranks the highest. And then there are other countries that are in between. India is sixth, Pakistan is seventh, Afghanistan is eighth. This is at regional level. Then you can see the ranking at the global level. So at the global level, what you can see is that Bangladesh ranks 65, whereas other countries like Nepal is at 106, Maldives is at 128, India is at 140. So what it is basically saying is that for policymakers, for international organizations, we need to work together to actually close the gap and also empower women. So that is why I was mentioning that this training, which is provided by ESCAP and other international partners, is basically trying to do this. It is trying to close the gap in terms of the gender divide. Then also, because I've previously mentioned that COVID-19 has resulted in deeper digitalization, but then also caused digital divide, then in the South Asia context, if we look at the gender parity, that means the gap between males and females in technical, in tech roles, there is still a huge gaps, right? For instance, in India, the gender gap is 4.31. And then in Bangladesh, it is 3.91. In Sri Lanka, it's 4.67. In Nepal, it's 3.96 and so forth. So what it is basically trying to tell us is that we need to train, we need to empower more women to engage in the digital economy by also engaging them in and training them to use the know-hows of technology. And the latest, this slide and the latest slide basically shows the countries' rankings individually, as I've previously shown in the first slide. But very interestingly, if you just look at this circle on this slide, what it actually shows is that if we are to, for instance, in Bangladesh, if we are to improve or close the gender gap that exists, then we need to do more economic participation and create more opportunities for women. And also we need to give them, integrate them more in terms of giving them more political empowerment and leadership roles. The same is true for Bhutan as well, in terms of engaging women in the economy and also giving them political empowerment. Likewise, for India, it is the same. For Iran as well, for Maldives, and the same is for Nepal, Pakistan, even Sri Lanka, Turkey. So again, as mentioned, that is why you know, we need to collaborate and also work with women entrepreneurships and also broader organizations to provide practical solutions in terms of closing this gender digital divide, because only then we will have global economic growth. Because as already shown, that relative to the male population, female population is also almost 50%, and it is going to rise. So females will become critical in the global economic development as well, and also they will be the major contributors of the gross domestic product for their countries. So in conclusion, I just want to give some final remarks. So as mentioned, the future of workforce will comprise of female population relative to male population. As already mentioned, the female population will also be very significant. But then we also realize the pandemic has increased the need for deeper digitalization. But then we also learned that digital divide has worsened. We need to therefore use technology or integrate technology as the fifth factor of production. And women, as mentioned, will form a major share of the global labor force. Therefore, it is quite important for us to develop soft digital infrastructure, meaning capacity building and training for women. And at the policy level, we need to ensure that we have gender sensitive recovery strategies, which will be critical in the post-COVID-19 economic recovery. Now, on this slide, what we have done, as I've mentioned in my first slide in the presentation, that last week we had actually launched the first self-paced course on digital infrastructure and digital divide. And this is a free self-paced course for anyone that would like to know more about what I have just presented. And it is open to Commonwealth member countries and non-Commonwealth member countries, and we are encouraging women to also take part in this. So if you are interested, you can actually enroll online. I will provide the link at the end, and then you can perhaps take the course. But this is basically showing in the later few slides, I'll just show how the outlook of the course looks like. So these are basically some of the topics or things which you will learn. And we have got a special section on gender digital infrastructure divide. And once you finish the course, you will get a certificate from the Commonwealth Secretariat too. And last week, week before last, when we launched it, we also had Dr. Rajan Ratna with us as well, who was part of the panel in terms of launching this first course. So this is how the course kind of looks like in terms of its outlook. And then once you will finish the course, then you will get a certificate from the Commonwealth with a QR code as well to just verify that you have done this course. So the registration link is here, and then the course will be starting from the 15th of October and will be going on until the 15th of March of 2022. So this will be the first batch of students that we will be training. And then I've also got some additional resources which I have also provided to Suvira. One is in terms of the recorded video for the course. So if you watch the video, you might know more about what the course is. And then if you are interested, you can register. And also I've got I've done a recorded video on how you can develop your own website in 30 minutes. And as mentioned, it's just a complimentary thing. It's not replacing this WeOnline portal that has been created, because I think in order to promote women from India and across South Asia, you need such a platform. Plus, if this is a very good initiative in terms of the WeOnline platform, and you know, I hope in future we could collaborate with the UNSCAP as well and perhaps have such trainings for other women in the 54 member countries of the Commonwealth from the regions which I have shared some of the gender divide data. And then perhaps there will be a broader network and market for women in trade as well. So with this is my contact details. So if you have any further queries, you can contact me or even, you know, contact ESCAP as well. And then I can address your questions. And then this ends my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Radhika. It was really an insightful session with the details and the numbers really giving a glimpse into what the real situation is. We have a question coming in, Dr. Radhika, about the course that you mentioned and the link to register. I would be grateful if you could share the details.
Yes, I can put the detail, the link on the chat as well.
Yes,
and I think I've given it to Suvira as well. Do you have it?
Ma'am, if you could share it on the chat box. Also with regard to your link for your the other links that you had shared with me, I have them downloaded. So I'll share with all the training material with the participants at the end.
Okay. Thank you. So I'm just going to share the link for the registration of the course here.
Yeah. And the floor is now open for anyone to ask questions before we close the session. If anyone has any questions, raise your hand or you could put it on the chat box. Radhika, you sent the message to me. Would it be possible to put it to everybody?
Oh, sorry.
also, Radhika, there's a question coming in. Is there any scholarship fund for women in the Commonwealth?
So in the Commonwealth Secretariat, we don't have a scholarship for women, but then we have got the Association of the Commonwealth Universities, and they usually have got Commonwealth scholarships, right? So what I can do is perhaps maybe after this, I can share the information with Suvira, and then you can share with those who might be interested, and you can apply for that scholarship as well. And I think you get a scholarship to study in UK and things like that. Yeah. So I think.
Do you have any link or any website link that you could share on the chat box that I think that they can further then go on that and share?
Okay, sure. Let me just quickly.
There's another question coming in. Are there any charges involved?
For this course, no, it is free.
And okay, so Anita has also raised her hand. Anita, you may go ahead, please.
Yeah, I would like to know about the fees. Is there any fees for this course?
No, it is basically, it is totally free. So there is no fees for it. And all women from all over the world can enroll. So, or men as well. So this is open to men and women.
Yeah, that's great news. Can you please upload the link here so that we can register?
Yes. I've put the link. I'm going to put the link again for this one. So course registration. And I just want to say one more thing. I've also done the course with Escape on the VSL online. It's really good as well. Very practical.
Are you mentioning about the e-learning course?
Yes, I mean, yeah. So I've put the link to the e-learning course for the Commonwealth, but then I'm just sharing with everyone. I've also done the VSL online course for that UNSCAP actually provided, and it's really good.
Okay, so I think there are no more questions. Thank you so much, Dr. Adhika. It was a really insightful session. And as said earlier, I have received your videos and will share with all the participants along with the presentation link. Thank you so much for everyone now that you joined today for all the sessions of VSL Online, where we learned how to register, upload our products, service catalog, and we had a good interaction with all the people who, all the participants here, and a very insightful session by Dr. Radhika. Before we close today's sessions, I would like to raise three things with everybody. One, we had also shared a survey that for a study that we are doing, and I'll share that survey link with everybody. It's on impact of COVID on women entrepreneurs. I will encourage everybody to just take 2 minutes for you, and we'll pause for a moment where everybody could just log in on this link I shared on the from the chat box and fill up this survey in case you haven't done it as yet. Because all the responses that you give would be helpful for us to understand the real impact that COVID has had on women entrepreneurs. We'll pause here. If anybody has any questions on the survey, you feel free to check with us. I am hoping that if not now, you're able to, you can save this and you can do it later in the evening. Yes, Deepshika, if you've done the survey yesterday, you don't need to repeat. So I'm only sharing it with everyone who haven't done it and would want to do it today. I am secondly sharing with you the e-learning course link of UNSCAP that we have shared, that Dr. Rajan had spoken about yesterday. This is again a free e-learning course. It has 4 modules, and once you complete, you get a certification certified by UNSCAP and EIF. And I'll encourage everybody to register and do this before tomorrow, so that everybody is up to date on knowledge front. In case you have any questions, you can connect with me or my team at info@VSL Online. Can I request my technical team to share a coordinates for the email addresses, please? Thirdly, I hope everybody has joined the Facebook group and the Instagram link accounts that we had shared with all. In case you haven't, I'll request my technical team to please share the links again so that everybody can join. So I forgot to share. One of the participants had shared with me the e-learning course certificate that she completed yesterday evening. And let me share that with everybody and you can have a look at it. One moment. So I hope everybody is able to see. Congratulations, Deepti, on completing this course. And I'll encourage everybody to take this course. It won't take much of time, but it's really good learning for everyone, all the budding women entrepreneurs there. And this is for all the males also. So any male, female entrepreneurs, you can go ahead, do this course on digital marketing and e-commerce. And also, anybody has any questions on anything on VSEL Online, or we have a chat box, the details have been shared, feel free to write to us. We've also taken all your contact numbers, so you could. We'll be creating the WhatsApp group. Most of you got added. Those who've shared it now will be done by tomorrow. So that's it for today's session. Now look forward to meeting everybody tomorrow. And tomorrow, everybody, I hope everybody is fully enthusiastic for coming tomorrow. We'll have a session, good 1 hour long session where everybody will get a chance to showcase your products and services, and do networking and connect with all the fellow participants, along with raising inquiry on VSEL Online. So look forward to meeting everybody tomorrow. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone. In case anyone has any question, if you want to ask, you can do so. Thank you.